Yeah, so welcome everyone. Welcome to this last lesson, lesson 6 on TP audit issues and appeal by Ms. Ho Yi Hui.
Today is the last session of the series of my TP webinar. Okay, it's already the lesson 6. Time flies, it's very fast. Okay, so earlier the 5 lessons I have talk about mainly the preparation of the TP doc. Okay, so today I will mainly talking about handling of TP audit. Okay, what is TP audit? How to go about the process? Okay, what is going to happen during the TP audit? Okay, and what is the common issue that normally Abi will look into it? When they find out during the TP audit, what are the common issues? And of course, I will also share with you, and for that kind of scenario, how are you going to deal with the issue? Okay, just a suggestion. Okay, it's not the answer to the solution. Okay, just a suggestion, because every time audit issue and then the proposed solution, how you to settle the case, is all different, case to case basis. Okay, because of course all the cases are handled by different officer. Okay? Different officer, they will have their different view, different interpretation of the law and regulation. So sometimes it's also very depends on who is the officer who handle your case. Okay. And then TP audit issue, and as well as how to go about the appeal. So according to the penalty, IRB can actually impose under statement of tax, which is under the 1132. Okay, the penalty that they can impose is up to one time of the tax underpaid. Okay, so for example, like let's say after the potential tax TP audit adjustment, the tax payable, the additional tax payable is 100,000. RB will have the right under this provision of Act 1132 impose another time of undercharge tax amount equivalent to 100,000 as the penalty. So your additional tax plus the penalty will be 100 plus 100K. So both is 200,000. Okay, so this is the provision under the law, under the Income Tax Act.
Yeah.
Okay, Sherry is asking, wow, so small. Can make it bigger?
Can.
Bigger a bit. Ah, okay. Section 140, big A, 3C, surcharge on all cases, whether taxable or not. That means penalty of 50% on TP audit no longer apply, right? And no, there's no clarification. And then in the act, they didn't say that the section 140A, 3C and 1132 are mutually exclusive. Okay, just take note of that, Cheryl. My answer is no. Okay, you still have two different provision on the two different kind of TP tax penalty. Mm-hmm.